decided I wasn't gonna make a video, but as you can see on the map, I was spawned up here when I logged in, and on the map it was showing a little settlement here. And as I came up to the shore, pretty nice view here. Over there is the settlement. And I could probably show you just a little bit about what you can find there. So I don't hear any activity right now, so I assume I'm safe. So I'm just going to kind of walk freely through here without worrying too much. Now the water here, you can, if it's deep, if it's deep, you won't be able to move. And if it's a slope, you could slide in and drown to death. So you can't swim in this thing. So you can kind of see where the ground is under the water. Usually that's where you can walk across. So over here. There is a settlement. And as you can see on your little settler mate right here, there's two little boxes on the settler mate, so you can go check out what's in there. Of course, I already came here. Just kind of went backwards to show you the settlement. And as you can see, there's a little more detail now that you're closer. That's the tall mountain over there that's on the other side of that is the bushwhack settlement. So here you have a big crate that usually means you have a lot of stuff in it. Doesn't always mean it's good stuff. The only thing I took out of here was some of this high-grade health. And the rest of this stuff I don't use because I have guns. Triceratops collar is good if you want to hunt a bunch of trike. It also attracts attention too, so if you hear a T-Rex and you don't want to really run all the way over to him, sometimes you can blow off that thing a few times or more and he will show his face. He'll walk closer to you. So it is good for that as well. As you can see here, I have some slug ammo, that's for the shotgun. I have a Talon hunting bow, which is a compound bow. I'm going to show you a little bit of that at a later time. That's good for killing trike and Utah raptor. This is the anti-personal rifle, that's different than the regular rifle. It just feels a little bit better when I shoot, when I use this one. I don't know if it's actually better or worse than the other one, but I like this one better. So anyway, there's a chest there, a big one. That usually means this has a lot of stuff in it. Then there's another chest over here, which is kind of a long one. That usually, again, doesn't really mean anything. It could still have junk in it. Now this one had slug ammo in it, so I took that out already. It had some camouflage there, same thing, a bow and arrow. It had this slug ammo in there, which of course I want. So that's what I took out. Now some of these settlements are actually nice. Like this is a pretty good one here. It has a lot of these things which you can hide behind if you're getting attacked by something. It even has this little low-grade thing, which I'm not sure if, if you were getting attacked by a T-Rex. He might still kill you under there, I'm not sure. But certainly it would block his walking. You know, you could probably play around with him a little bit. Or a Utah. Now this one I can go out. Even over this. But when I come back, can't get in that way. Have to go all the way around these spikes. So test that before you decide you want to run out and aggro something in case you figure you have enough time to run in and you get caught on the fence. Now a lot of these you can kind of, you can't go in those little holes, but like for instance, let me see if you can shoot through. Sometimes you have invisible walls. It looks like it's an opening, but it's really not. But I think this one probably will be okay to shoot through. So. Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell. But I didn't see any like wood chips flying, so that was probably an okay hole. Same with this one. That one may be okay there too. And like T-Rex can't get through here. Definitely not. So they will walk around maybe, but a lot of times if they come against these fences, they'll just get stuck. So I think I can walk out here. See, I can walk through there. Now a T-Rex probably can't get through here either, so I don't know if there's any T-Rex around here. So anyway, so that's a settlement, you know, that's a really nice one, because you have a lot of holes you can peek through and be protected, but of course a settlement like that is really kind of worthless if there's nobody around, but it's good for the Utah? I'm gonna go up here just for a little bit. I don't want to bore you too much on this video, but the game is, you know, beautiful. I mean, I just love running, walking around it, even though it's a limited size island. But you know, it's pretty big, Primal Eden. I mean, this guy here, I'm here and he's there. That's about 3,000 meters. So. It's a pretty big island. So I don't think I've been there yet before today. So that was pretty nice. I discovered a settlement. So I'm gonna see if there's any T-Rex up here, but I don't think there is. It seems like they're just on this. Oh, there's a Utah raptor. It just seems like basically the T-Rex really hang around here. Like from here up to here. Wow, Utah raptor, and I don't have any cover. Let me just get over here. Oh, there's a rock. So that could work to my advantage. Now Utah raptor, you will know they're around, it'll sound like a dog barking. Now I don't know if he's gonna come up this way or not. This is cool. Kind of changing, huh? I don't see brown too much. Let me get a screenshot. I don't see brown too much. Okay, here he comes. Now I heard a growl, so when you hear the growl, that means they're kind of not looking for you, but they know you're around for sure. It's kind of like an aggression noise. At least that's my perception of it anyway. Nice. He's farther away again now. I don't know if that's a new one or an old one though. excuse me. Well, I'm just gonna keep walking and take the chance. You know, I don't like messing with Utah. I mean, I just don't seem to have good luck when they rush up to me and I try shooting them. I'm much better, you know, using a machete on them or whatever. Pretty scene. Okay, he's around. Come on, buddy. Might be able to get in this tree here. Oh good, there's a nice spot there. I wonder if there's another stump. Okay, I don't know if you can hear the growl. But again, that's like a growl of aggression. So I'm gonna run around here. Try to get him to come to me. You know, if you kind of run, if you get on a rock or something, or like this stump, they may undetect you. So you just kind of run around, make a little noise, until you hear their chirp. Yeah, there's the growl again. You can turn up, you know, I don't want to turn up my volume too much because you can't hear my voice, but. Sometimes they don't know what they want to do, though. Sometimes they won't make their chirping noise. All of a sudden, they'll just be here. So always be ready for them. Because if they see you from a distance, I mean, especially out in the open, they might just run right to you. I mean, you won't even have a warning. See, I'm a little more nervous here because I don't know this area. So definitely traveling around a bit to get to know your surroundings here definitely helps, because you'll know, like, places like this that I'm standing on right now, you'll know where trees are that you can hide in. Especially with Utah, it's because you don't know if it's 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, if you get attacked by 3 or 4, I mean, you're most likely dead. I mean, if you're not ready for them, because they're all going to be chewing on you. And that's definitely not what the doctor ordered. And something tells me it's probably going to start raining soon. But I don't hear anything, so... And you can get out your settler mate and see if anything's around. Now see, I just heard something again. I was too busy talking. And, you know, the best way to survive in this game is to listen. Because all the animals here that you have to kill make warning sounds. In fact, more than one warning sound. But it's best to hear the first one, the farthest one. Because even the T-Rex, I found out that if you get into an area where there is one in a fairly close proximity, you'll hear a really, 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 really faint roar. And I never noticed that until recently, when I had my volume turn up a little bit more. See, I don't know what's happening here. I don't know this area, so I'm gonna take it real slow. Now see, all these sounds that are happening right now don't mean anything. Now I'm hoping that someday, when they add more dinosaurs, that will mean something. But they just try to put all these noises in the woods just to make it a little more, you know. You know, I guess, feel like more realistic. I guess. Okay, there's the bark again. So there's a Utah raptor down below here. Now these kind of woods here, you're gonna find velociraptors, which are the little guys, and you're gonna find Utah raptor. Alright, see, some of these you can climb up on too. But again, once you go up on these, I never heard really too many of these sounds before. Sounds like people are screaming. But anyway, pretty scary sometimes, huh? This is an excellent place to shoot a T-Rex from. Just don't let him see you, because he can come up here and then eat you. Utah raptor, they probably can't get you up here unless they're on this side. But a lot of times, if you're already up here, you get on the highest part where they can't reach you, and then they can't bite you. So, I'm gonna go over here because I see a tree with a hole in it, so. If a Utah raptor decides they want to run after me, at least they got some cover. Now these stumps, you can only climb up on one side, which would be the side with the slope here. See, he's still out here. He's probably wandering around. Sometimes, like I said, that's all you'll hear is the growl, and then he'll just run up to you all of a sudden. See, there's one closer. There's a bark. That's a farther one. And then there's one closer. Now, if I go over here and eat these eggs, I'm definitely gonna attract them. He's over that way. Because the eggs will put the scent on you. Come on. I need a kill. Come on. Try to get him to chase me. If you run especially, they will hear that. This game takes patience. Sometimes. Now, of course, I can go after him. You know, and I know people who are very confident, and, you know, they'll go after them, because sometimes it's better. Because then you won't get taken by surprise. But these guys are being very elusive. They usually definitely come after you. Now, you know, they could very well be stalking me. There isn't too many more trees around for me to hide in. So I'm kind of looking around here. See what my options are here. There's something there, but I don't know if I can climb that. It's not real clear at all with this lighting. These Utahs are being really, really elusive. This is their territory. Now there's a stump here. I don't know if I can climb up there. Yep. I still don't feel very comfortable at all. So anyway, this is just one thing you can do, go from tree to tree. Especially if you definitely know you're being stalked, you can kind of get a visual. of what's going on and then still be safe. Oh yeah, I wanted to show you the mushrooms. I forgot about it. Okay, there he is again. If you heard the dog barking. He's up in this hill here. Now if this was like a plane, you'd be able to see him. Way off in the distance, but... unfortunately, it's very difficult to hear. Or see, I'm sorry. See who's where, and I'm not sure why. They're being so elusive. See, hear them? One of my friends are on. We're just really far apart. A little choppy right now because I'm uploading a video to YouTube. I'm not sure if it's going to take it or not because it's so big. Thought I saw something over there, but... could have been a leaf falling. Yeah, it's a nice game though. Yeah. Even though you could say it's unfinished, as most people are complaining about. You know, it's definitely... ooh, this one doesn't have a hole. Ooh, see, these trees are bigger than they look. You see, basically I'm just gonna go from... tree to tree. Can be nerve-wracking, especially since I don't know where I am. Let me see. Okay, so I'm kind of heading back to towards Bushwhack. I mean, I could go over this way, but I went this way before and there really wasn't a whole lot of T-Rex over there on this eastern side. I mean, there is, but not many, at least from my experience. I mean, it could be loadout. I mean, you know, each time you start a server it might change, I guess. These are little cracks you can hide in too. Obviously they're not as safe, but... If you got nowhere to hide, and there's another Utah up this hill here, I'm gonna try to get closer to him to try to bring him back to me. For some reason they don't want to attack. I don't know why. I'm not exactly sure what's going on with these guys. Yeah, I hear them. Now you get, now some of these trees crackle too, so you have to be careful. It sounds like growling, but it's really the tree. Which is kind of cool, actually, that they do that. See, again, I don't know this area, so I don't even know if this tree here has a hole in it. Looks like it does. Okay, good. So this one has one. Now, these are the best kind of trees here to go in, especially if a T-Rex is hunting you, because they're on a slant. So he can't stick his head in here as easily. Something. I mean, I heard a dog bark again, but it was far away. See, that's the trees creaking. And then sometimes you will walk in this game for a while and not see anything. And sometimes you can't walk between trees. So that's another reason why you should know the area. Oh, I heard him. He was a little closer. Why he's waiting, I don't know. Oh, right there, see the track? I don't know if it, that's a... See, there's one, I think, starting to stalk me. See, I didn't have my settler made out. See? Utah raptor. Oh, it's gonna start to rain. Which makes it a little harder to hear them, but also I think makes it a little harder for them to hear you too. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to get up on this other stump here, and I can't get through here. There's two stumps here. I may not be able to get up this one. See, there's a big circle on my settler mate, so that means they're just kind of roaming around this area here. So since I got a box that way, so that I see two trees ahead of me. One of them looks like it has a hole in it, so. For that one. I just heard him bark again from a distance. a shame I missed. There's two boxes. There's one that way and one that way. See, I'm taking a risk coming up here. I can't see a thing. If you turn up the volume, you can really hear a lot of detail. Even my footsteps, which are very loud. Now see up here. Don't really have any cover. That's not a good thing. And there's a slope I can't get up. That's not a good thing. So if I get attacked, I'm really like wide open for Utah supper, or a Utah snack, I should say. Now here you can go up on the hill. Get a nice view of what's going on. There's the volcano, I think. I can hear a trike or a triceratops. See? Down there is where the settlement was that I took you to before. There it is right there. Interesting, huh? So you can see how big this place is. Now, there's triceratops around here somewhere. But what I'm going to do is get to that box before the Utah decide that they want to come after me. Now you'll hear that noise. Now it'll, if you have a headphone surround sound or something, then you'll be able to tell if it's right or left. And there's a slug shot. Let's see, I can only take five. So I'm getting rid of the compound arrow because I'd rather have bullets. So I guess I'll show you that some other day. Maybe I'll just take the arrows in case I find a... Ooh. Night Lords was killed by a T-Rex. Now that's a triceratops noise. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oops, shoot. Good gracious. Alright, so there's Night Lords. I want to try to catch up to him because apparently he just got killed by a T-Rex, so. I still don't like this situation I'm in, but I do know this area a little bit more. So like right there is Bushwhack. So here's a Triceratops' feet. And that tells you that he's kind of in that direction. But of course they're big, so they when they walk, you know, pretty good distance. Now, I could shoot this guy. But since my friend is being was killed by a T-Rex, I want to save my ammo. Now if I get attacked by a trike, now that's some poop. That's probably a different one. It'll actually it gives you details. Weight. Sometimes male or female. So that one's a pretty heavy one. Now if you get close to these guys, they will attack you. Yeah. Sometimes I just like looking just in case it's a Utah. But that's a Triceratops. See, female. Uh-oh. I just heard a T-Rex. Yep. Yes, sir. Huh. I'm gonna get up here. Where am I on the map? Yeah, there is a good spot to shoot this guy from. I have to get up on this, right here, on this slope, right here. Ah. That's terrible. When you have headphones, man. That's loud. Now I have, there's a good spot to shoot this guy, if I can get to it. If this is, if he's close enough, hopefully. Whoa! Oh, he's attacking. He's attacking me. He might kill me. Gonna stay here because I don't want to use my ammo. I mean, he still wants to attack me. I might have to kill him. I don't want to. Get out of here. Normally I would just blow him away with this ammo, but I really want to save it. But, I mean, if he really wants to fight. Cruising for a reason. Whoa. God, I hate this aim sight. I heard him. See, now he's running away. Scaredy cat. There's one for good luck. See, that's why I didn't want to bother. Wasting my ammo now. Although that's buckshot, so that ain't too bad. See, now the T-Rex might be gone now. And this isn't the hill that I wanted to be at. He messed me up now, that guy. I should track him and kill him. I gotta get over to the other hill. I tell you, he's dead meat if I see him again. see how much I hurt him. Not too bad. You figure that's because I was hitting him in the face. I mean, oh, he's not even believing. Ridiculous. Now where is that T-Rex? Fleeing, okay, so... gotta find out where that T... See, he messed up, messed me up now with the T-Rex. Cause, now I probably can't aggro him over to this hill. He might be down in this valley though. Of course, here comes the rain again. Where's that? The moon. Be her. It might be the hurt one right there. Yep. I'm trying to hate to waste my ammo, but if I can get a good shot, I should be able to take her out. Now if she sees me, she's gonna run. If I get a good shot at the neck, I might be able to do it. Oh, come on. Yeah, it's not gonna be an easy shot. There she goes. Yeah. Should have killed her, but that's not how it works. You gotta shoot vital organs more than once. Now where did this guy go, this T-Rex? He walked away pretty far, fast. Now where is Night Lord's going? He's actually going farther away. That's my hill right there. Yeah, see, he just ran again. She saw me. Now, if you get up on top of that hill and you see a T-Rex anywhere down here and shoot at him, he ain't gonna get up there. And she just ran again. It's a T-Rex, eh? I don't even see, like, is she running again? Every time I get close to her, she's running. I might end up shooting her later. Well, that T-Rex has to be somewhere near here, because I mean, he could have walked along the beach. Oh. Thank you. one that I heard had to be different. Oh. Got him. Okay, good. Yep, I do have another one. Where is he? Yep, he's here. I got two. Two of them. Move. God, it's rain. I don't know who's closer. I got two here though. Pretty sure. It's just rain. I wish it would stop. Very annoying. Well, I'm gonna take a chance here. See, he came out of nowhere, this guy. Now if I can get up my favorite hill here. Is he? There he is, right there. Shoot. Wow, it's pretty far away. Oh boy. Well, I'm just gonna have to shoot him and bring him over here. And that's really the best I can do. Because that hill's way too far away. He'll catch up to me real quick. So maybe I can just get a couple good shots at him. And run! Maybe if I shoot him from up here. Where is he? Gosh, they walk away so fast. Well, that's really nice distance. He might go out of my range. He might stop, yeah. Time to run. Save some stamina. Go through the hole in the fence. Now he's gonna come over this hill, so probably. That's a good thing. Come on, guy. Really? Here he comes. He's staying right behind the hill. And that's something. Come on. I can't shoot him. Come on. See him. Here he comes. No. Yeah, he's walking away. Don't do that. Come out and play. I just hate this. I mean, it's not really a big deal, it's just that you can't get too far away because your stamina is so little that if you put yourself too far away, then you're not going to be able to run back. And they get stuck, they stay behind these hills where you can't see them. Now see, I'm actually getting pretty far from this. Now if he sees me, he's going to charge me, that's the problem. So I just have to... Oh, he's way out there again. Jesus. Alright, no problem. Come on, get up. Hoping if I go on this side, that's where he'll try to come get me. He's going up that hill again. Let's see, I might be able to get him through here. Sometimes you can't see. I heard him. See, when they get down on their knees like that. Are getting haha, good job. Woohoo! Got him. Ooh, another. Oh, 20%. Are you kidding me? Jeez, unbelievable. How did that happen? Oh, look at that. Yeah. Funny. Oops. Darn. Yeah, I don't know, steel. Yeah, that all that. Alright, so, well, you ended up seeing us kill two T-Rex. That's with two people, of course. Ooh, look who this is. A Quetzl. I heard a bird. Let's see who he's gonna attack. There you go. You know. There's another bird, but I don't want to get attacked by another Triceratops either. Might kill me, but I hope not. Sorry, I'm not talking very much. I'm just kinda... Well, YouTube video must be done. Okay, so we can go. Yeah. Yeah, that guy up on the ridge. Just sitting up there, waiting to be shot at. Super lag. Phew. Wow, look at that one. Whoa, what is up with the lag? Oh, that's because I'm doing the video. That's what it is. I probably ran out of space.